In this session, we'll be showing how to import payroll time in the construction payroll application within Sage Intacct. Within the software, you can import in payroll time through an import template. To grab and download that template, you can go to the payroll community, and we typically have it loaded up for you, a link. In your dashboard, you should see a Bangert deployment dashboard. And in there, we have, as one of the recommended sites, the Sage Intacct Construction Payroll community. If you click on that, that will take you into the Construction Payroll community area, and it's under help.cloudpayrollengine.com. And if you go into search here and type in import time, you'll notice here that it comes up to an import file, time cards. You can click on that, and there's instructions on how to import time cards. More importantly, down at the bottom, you'll notice a time card Excel file. And this is a sample import format that you can use to base your export file on from wherever you're gathering your time from. If I click on that, it'll download it into my downloads folder. And I will open that up to take a look at it. And they provide you with a default template with explanations on each column and some examples of what you need and what column for the time to be imported into the system. Now, even without that template, the import is designed to allow you to match up the columns. So even if you have different column headings, you'll have an opportunity to sync up and map each column to how it imports in. So we'll show you that next. So with this template, it is available for your use. You don't have to make it exact, but if you have the column headings labeled the same, then it will make the mapping easier in the next step. I have an example for that ready to go. I'm going to open up my example, which is import time week ending 128. So I have a sample import with some data in there that we're going to import into the system here. So, you know, there's certain columns that requires, but it'd be employee ID, job number, cost type, cost code, work date, hours type, and hours. So we'll show that importing into the system. I'm going to go back into Sage Intacct now, and I will go over to Construction Payroll, and you can do this right from within Timecards under Construction Payroll, or you can go down to Imports and get into the Import Time section. We're going to do it right from the time card. We'll click on time cards. And you'll notice over on the right side, you have a import button. So we can click import. And it brings us right into the import section of the system. And we're going to say import rows. Now, a nice little feature you do have, even before you bring in the Excel file, you can manually, right from the import screen, enter time in here. So if you find it easier than entering it into the other area, you know, you could come into here and say GC 101 and fill out the required information for the jobs and so forth. And it will check it to make sure it meets the IDs and all that are required. You could do that manually. Or in this scenario, I'm going to click import rows and I'm going to update data from a file. So I'm going to click on that file that we just looked at, the import time week ending 128. I'll select that file. It'll bring the file in and it'll verify each of the columns for us. I'm going to click continue. And now this is where it's going to map the column headings to the Sage Intacct column headings. So if your heading names are different, you will have to manually link them and map them over, but you can do that. These are already mapped because they are the same name, so they mapped automatically. And at this point, I would click review. And now it's going to show and bring in all of the data. And I have one issue here, and it's saying invalid employee identifier. And the reason it's saying that is if you'll notice, and if you watched our prior session for manual entry, I'm at the wrong entity. I'm in the top level. so it doesn't recognize these employees at the top level. So what I would do is switch over to GC, my payroll company, and try that import again. So now I'm switched over to the correct entity. I'll click import, import rows, upload data, grab that file. It'll load it up. And there's our mappings again. I'll click review. And now you'll notice there's no errors. There's no red. And you can see here only show rows with problems. So if I had a large import file and there was some errors, I could slide this button over and it's only going to show me the lines that have errors. And at this point, you still have an opportunity to edit this file. So if you realized that this was coded to the wrong job, you could come here and make that 20006. And you can make edits on the fly here as well. Once your data looks good, you're going to click continue and say you're ready to submit. Click yes. And it's added 40 rows. Now, none of this gets saved into the time card until you click this last step, which is save records. So we'll go ahead and click save records. And once that is complete, I'll be able to go view those imported time entries, the 40 time cards, in the time card area, which I can get to right from this open time cards button. I do have to select my week again. So I would select pay group, weekly, hourly, the week I imported, which was the 28th, and click view timesheets. And now you'll notice I have time entered into the system for these employees, which I can then go into the system and review and approve, which is in our next step. So if there was additional time that you needed to enter, you can go in and enter it manually or do a second import or third import file and keep accumulating that time during the week. And that's how to import time in Sage Intacct Construction Payroll. Thank you.